What's going on, guys? It's your boy Stone. Today we're playing a Super Nintendo Verified Classic. Pretty underrated. This is ActRaiser, developed by Quintet, published by Enix. It's known for being an interesting blend between of genres, whereas you have 2D platforming stages with like hack and slash sword gameplay, and once you complete those, you go on to a sim element and build a town. And the more people you build in your town, the stronger you are in the platforming segments. So with that said, let's get to it. Alright, we're going to name ourselves. I'm going to be Stone. Shit. Stone. Are you awake? I'm the angel sent to help you recover your lost strength. Now, all types of monsters are in total control of the Earth. This all came about because of a demon they call Tanzra, the one who sealed your power. In order to restore your power, you will need to rekindle the people's faith in you. But first, let's go down to the Earth and destroy all monsters, that we may establish a peaceful land for our people to dwell in. So here we are, this is the main menu. First things first, I'm going to change the message speed to the fastest. We have our status here, we're level 1. And these are the populations of our towns. You see there are 6 towns in total. That's 12 platforming stages, including... and there's a bonus final stage where you refight all the bosses. It's really cool. We can... move the Sky Palace around town, but what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to start over Fillmore, which is the starting area, and we can't observe any people because no one inhabits it yet. So in order to get that to happen, we have to do the platforming stage by clicking Fight Monsters. So here we are. I'm going to try not to make a big fool of myself, as I often do when I commentate and play games and at the same time. Because the skill, you know, when you're commentating, it's like a known fact that your skill in video games is cut in half. But I've been practicing, so I'm not completely lost. A little known fact about this is that you want to build up as much points as you can in the platforming stages. Because... the more points you get in total between the two platforming stages for each world affects how many people you can have in your town at the end of the day. So, you can go back, enemies respawn if you want to grind. You can grind it out, but I find minimal grinding is needed. You can just fuck around on these tree branches. I think there might be something interesting. Ah. Nothing. Absolutely nothing up there. So we got this guy. He shoots fireballs, but sometimes you can swat projectiles away with your sword, which is a great defensive maneuver. Most of the times you can't. Oh, took damage there. I got a one-up. So basically... swatting projectiles back, usually it's the magical fire and stuff that you can do, but like when little gremlins throw knives at you, like you might see a little, like soon. Ah, there's an apple, that's health. So we got this like monkey guy. Even the bees. Now, every time you get hit, shit. It always takes the same amount of, damage away, no matter what you're getting hit by, which is cool. You're gonna want to break these crystal orbs. They have little special things. Like I just got another one up, and the more one ups you have, the more points you get at the end of the stage, and also the more chances you get to do the stage over from checkpoints, as opposed to if you die, you'd have to do the whole stage from the beginning. So it's kind of bullshit. There's my health. Now, because usually you get health right before a boss encounter. So we got this guy. He's a centaur. We're going to want to bait him over to the edge over here. And you can duck under this. And you can get a good couple hits in on him. It's possible to not take any damage in this battle. And he does that magic spell, but it's easily avoided, and bam! I just took him down, taking no damage. Now, I'm not good at video games, really, but that took some practice, because I remember when I first played that stage, I completely just messed up on that guy. In fact, every boss that I fought blind, I had no idea what I was doing. So here we are at the Sim element. And you see, we just summon two people. We start with two people in every town. We start all the towns from scratch. And we're guided by our little cherub angel friend, who we can control. And I'll explain in a moment. He's basically just explaining it. First, the people will talk to us in our shrine because we're playing the role of God. So we're their deity. So what they're saying is the bushes are impeding their progress. So what we're going to have to do is we can tell them where to build. And what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to build towards these monster areas. Once you build up enough people, and you get more people by killing monsters and developing the town, you'll see it goes on like a grid-based structure. You see they're going up. Town is under construction. Now I can't input any commands in the menu while they build, and they're building fields and houses, and those contribute to how many people can join the town, which is great. So now we're up. Oh, town's under construction again. I was going to show you the miracles. Miracles are a cool little thing. Like you said, they said there's too many bushes impeding them. Let's see what they got to say. We finally mastered the skill of hunting animals. Oh, good. This means they can actually destroy the monster lair. And that happened because you can only do that when you have more than 10 people in your town. So you see in the top right, I have 14 people out of 0014. That's 14 people in this town out of my total number of followers across the whole region. So since we're only doing one town, we only have 14 total. And the SP is like magic points that we can cast miracles with. And that goes up as we level up. The more people that we have following us, because we're God, the higher your levels are and the more HP you'll have in the platforming stages, as well as the more SP you'll have to cast miracles. Now, once the town is not under construction and they stop talking to me, okay, so the guy's saying that he's psychic and he's telling us to go into the forest, which is over here. So you see, I just casted a miracle where a lightning bolt came down and it just raises the earth and destroys any impediments or any trees. Now what you're going to want to do is, in this game, population is king. So what you're going to want to do, it's in your best interest to clear out all obstacles and then have the people develop their town upon every space on the board. And there's other factors like the quality of homes. So since we're a level one town, they're building like the shittiest homes, like mud huts. Level two towns can build log cabins, and level three towns can build like full-on good houses, which hold even more people per house. So that gets all your populations up and stuff. So that's good. Okay, they have something to tell me. Fire broke out in the home in the north. So what they want me to do is to cast rain. And I can do that, and bam, I put out the fire. And so that happens occasionally where you can interact with your people, but it's very scarce. It's very scarce. It's few and far between. But it's a nice little interaction that you can have with your people. So what I'm going to want to do is I'm going to want to clear the remaining trees here so I can have my people develop across this river. Now, there's a weird mechanic in this where you can build bridges across rivers. We haven't gained that ability yet, but it's kind of detrimental to have too many bridges because bridges take up what a house would, like a tile that would hold a house or something. And the less houses you have, the less people you have, and bridges contribute nothing. So you want to have as little bridges as possible. Okay, so my level increased because I got 70 people or whatever. My HP goes up. And my SP will go up as well. See, now I have 45 to play with. This is good because now I can clear the rest of the trees. Now you'll see that as the cherub, I'm shooting little monsters on the screen with arrows. This is good because not only do you gain SP back and can cast more miracles, but you can also defend your town from being destroyed. And that's good. So we're going to have them go after this guy. It's kind of a long process. You see that bat just picked up four people? So they can steal people. The blue dragons can straight up kill people and destroy one house at a time. And also, if you run into the blue dragons, it does damage to you. See, the angel has HP. Now, if the angel loses HP, it's not too bad. You just can't defend your town until the next construction phase, where you'll gain some HP back. Now, in the Japanese version, you gain HP back gradually, but in this, I don't know, they rebalanced it. So they're saying there's something under a rock that I can destroy with my magic. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's destroy the rocks. And immediately my people will have something to say about that. They revealed something below, and now the people have something to say. So they found something. They found an offering. So this is good. So they say they found items, but they don't give it to you immediately. You have to go into the menu and take an offering, and it'll give you what they found. So they found a bomb, and they found magical fire, which is a spell that we can use on the platforming stages, which will come in handy once we get some magic scrolls. Magical fire is not the best magic in the game, but it's not bad, especially for the first levels. So, we're just gonna make our way downtown. I'm just gonna kill a couple more enemies, and basically what you gotta do is you gotta destroy. The goal is to get rid of every single monster layer. Then there'll be one final platforming challenge, and then the world is complete. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna finish Fillmore today. And then we'll move on to Bloodpool, and we'll just take it at a town at a time, you know? A town at a time. The only thing about the sim segments is that it just takes a while for them to build up resources. You see them, like, building houses? So they're building, like, the tier one houses. At one point, I think when we destroy another monster lair, as we're getting there. To destroy the monster lair, you just have to be next to the monster lair. You don't have to actually be on the space. So see, once they move one space over, they'll be able to take on the lair. See, now they're going at it. And that's good, because then that means less of these annoying pieces of shit are going to spawn. So they say they find something as an offering. So that's what I'm saying. It should take me right to the offering screen. So I found Strength of an Angel. That's a good item, but I'm not going to use it now. Basically, what it does is it increases the damage you do as the angel form. Meaning you can destroy stronger enemies in one hit rather than three, like those blue dragons take. But the blue dragons aren't much of a threat, and they do get stunned when you attack them. So I'm just going to leave them, I'm just going to leave the strength of the angel for a later stage where it might actually come in more handy to me. So basically everything runs on a timer. You see in the top middle of the screen, there's an hourglass that's slowly counting down or changing sides or whatever. That determines how many cycles of construction, like where you are, I think. So we're doing pretty good. Our level increased because we got even more people, and it tells you how much more people you need for your next level. So we need 400 for our next level. People have something to say. Ah, they found a scroll while fishing. So what's a scroll? Source of magic basically gives us one magic charge to use on the platforming stage. So let's move our boys and girls up again. Into the forest. I'm going to use my final lightning miracle to take out these last trees, and then we should get to, we should be able to take everything. You know, sometimes the enemies aggro really fast, and sometimes they just don't. So it's kind of a crapshoot, really. I'm doing really shitty here. The sim section is interesting, but it's mostly like a relaxing time. I've never really found myself being too annoyed. There's a couple enemies that we'll see later in the game that can really grind your, you know, really push your buttons, but overall the difficulty in this game really comes from doing the platform stages, because I feel you don't have many options defensively or in the platforming stages, and enemies, they do everything they can to hit you and just chip away your damage. So you see how he's carrying those people, and I attack them and they all fall down? If I attack them over land, they'll be put back into my population and be completely safe. However, if they are dropped over a body of water, they unfortunately drown. Now, I think that's 4 people at a time, so it's not that bad. So what we're going to do is we're going to build down, up, and it follows your cursor, everything you do. So this should be able to take out that last monster layer. So they found a scroll in the woods. That's good. That's another source of magic. And those things are good, because you want to build up as many of those, because you get a spell later called Stardust, which absolutely shreds the larger bosses of this game. And sometimes it can be your greatest ally, and sometimes it can be your biggest detriment, is to cast those magic spells. And even if you die in a platforming stage, the spells do not refill, so as far as I know, it's safer to just bring the spells into the boss encounters, and as long as you have enough HP, you think you can just nuke them, and everything will be fine. But as you'll see, the Stardust spell is not 100% reliable. It has its quirks. Jesus. Usually the enemies don't aggro this hard. It really feels like the last time I played through this game, the other towns, it was just Fillmore where they really went at me. I mean, in the later ones, you encounter some more annoying enemies that take like 6 hits to kill. But overall, they don't really come out in droves like they are now. Okay, civilization level has improved in Fillmore. That means they'll start building better houses than these shitty mud huts, which will in turn bring more people. And they learned how to build bridges, so we can build bridges over the lake. You'll see, one appeared automatically right there. So you're going to want to minimize your bridge usage here. Once they start developing here, I'll send them back to the last monster lair. There you go. Look at that. Look at my little boys and girls. All right, town's under construction. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a tactical fuck. Yeah, we're going to fuck them. Let's do it. Bam. And those should be the last few spaces. Ah, damn, I should have went the other way. Now they're going to build a bridge over there. That's okay. I'm not going for maximum population. I would like to be max level in this game. But if it doesn't happen, I'm not too worried. So this guy, he's been having a nightmare every night. And a Minotaurus is coming to him. So what we have to do is we have to lift this terrible curse. And you see, we destroyed all the monster layers. So now there's nothing left in town to do but fill all the squares. Possibly get another level up and then go take on the next boss. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna wait for them to fill these last two squares and then I'm gonna take on the boss. So we go back to the Sky Palace. Now this is important. Select the magical fire if you feel like you're gonna use it. I might use it. We'll see. So people will no longer be scared of evil as long as we take out the final threat. And this finishes the Fillmore chapter. So wish me luck, guys, because we're going into the crater. I really love the music of ActRaiser. It's really nice. The graphics are awesome. I love that you're playing as this, like, almost like Holy Paladin Knight. Oh yeah, you see this guy? Oh shit. Completely ate my input there, my jump. Blame the game. See, like that guy, you can destroy his magical fire. You got 1,000 points with those crowns. Bam. I just think some enemies just take way too many hits to kill. This is cool, you can kill them through the ceiling. Damn it. It just adds up, you know, because especially this stage, you don't really get health refills until later. And just distance problems. Don't go for that worm. He's a piece of shit. You don't need the points. Just keep trucking because the stage gets a little crazier as it goes on. These fucking guys, like, they throw their knives at you, but they okay. So I got a rotten apple. That's good. Fuck. See that? This guy's kind of a mini boss. He's not hard, but he hits like a tank. And that opens the way to the final part of the stage. So this is cool. You can just, you just want to play it safe. You don't want to run into fuck. Ah, the platforming section. Be careful of the worms. You're going to want to kill them first. And if you're slow, yeah, see the faces on the side will drip out like shit out of their walls. See, I wasn't paying attention, so I took that damage. You don't want to take damage. I mean, I know it's, ain't that the statement of the week? You don't want to take damage in a video game, but, because it all adds up, and there's, like, no way to refill health other than getting a lucky drop or knowing exactly where the health drops are. Like, I think this is a heart. Yeah, that's good. Now watch out, because I know that the UI is obscuring it, but there are little spikes that can fall from the ceiling, which is kind of a dick move, in my opinion. But I mean, what does my opinion count for anyway? So here we got this guy. He throws an axe and then he jumps down at your location, throws an axe and then jumps up and repeats. I can't believe I got hit. Oh wow, I'm playing really bad. So when you cast magic, you're invincible. So that's good. You want to jump over the axes, and you can do it without using any magic. I just wanted to show you guys the magic. So, I played really shitty there, but I ended up doing it, and the score helps, because the more score you have, see in the top right, the more maximum people you can have, and the higher the level you could achieve by the end of the game. So, getting 10,000 points on each stage is like the ideal way to get the maximum number of people. That and not building too many bridges. So unfortunately, this person is telling us that the other guy that was praying with us had passed away. The guy who could see the future or whatever. He had that intuition. But at least he helped us out. And he's a martyr now. In my religion, I'm going to make him Saint Jimmy. Saint Jimmy. Yeah, I'm going to make him Saint Jimmy. No relation to the Green Day people. So here we are. We've completed Fillmore. Do they have any offerings? They have the bridge. We can take the bridge. We'll need that in the next town. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on ActRaiser.